Hello, friends and subscribers. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to St. Bernard Acres. I've got some sonotubes to unload. It rained out here a lot yesterday and Friday night. It's very soupy. I'm afraid to drive down to the barn. So I'm going to carry, I mean, they're not heavy. I'm going to carry all these down to the barn. And then I'll be back and talk to you about foundations. If you can't figure out what I'm going to be doing from seeing these. But I've got 7 of these to unload. So I'll walk them down there and then I'll be back. You see who's sitting there waiting on me? Who's that? Alright, welcome to the barn. Those are 12-inch sonotubes, sonotubes they're called. They're for, they're forms, tube forms for pier foundations. That's what I'm going to have is a pier and beam foundation. You saw I brought all these 4x6s out. These are going to be the beams. The piers, now, they only had 7 of those. I ordered 8. I'm going to have 21 total piers for my 20x48 house. There's going to be 3 rows of 7 piers with beams on top of it. Why am I only getting 8 sonotubes? Well, I had to look at, 8 is sufficient. 8 is plenty, you know, for put them in the corners and in the middle and a couple in the middle. I had to look at it from a financial standpoint as well. And just economics dictate I do it like this. Those are 4 feet long. My frost line here is around 30 inches. I'm gonna go down 40 inches with the concrete and the rebar in those piers. That'll leave 8 inches above ground because I'm gonna have the foundation graded and put gravel down. Then these are gonna go down 40 inches. I'll leave 8 inches above ground. Then all of my blocks, I'm gonna put a 16 inch square 1x16 down, and the blocks, the 8x8x16 blocks, right? It'll be 8 inches above grade. These piers will be 8 inches above grade, if this makes sense. And then the beams running across it will be another 6 inches, another two before on top of that, another inch, you know. So I'm gonna be about 15 inches off the ground, which is plenty, because my plumbing is gonna be just a little bit of plumbing run underneath, that's it. I'm not gonna need all that underneath area. I don't need to be that high off the ground. So back to the economics of why I'm doing it that way. These piers cost $12 a piece, or these forms cost $12 a piece. They take 6 bags of sacre to fill them, 6 80-pound bags. Those are $6.50 a piece, a bag. So 6 of those are gonna be $38, plus the 12 for the tube. So now you're at $50, plus the rebar. You know, let's round it off to $60, because, you know, it's not just a piece of wire in the thing, it's a form I'm gonna put in them for the strength. So $60 per pier times the 21 piers. You're looking at $1,260 just to put the piers in. Now, that $60 pier, if I bought the square, the 16 by 16, and two cinder blocks, 8x8x16, to help with the foundation, not to support the whole thing, just to add support to it, you're looking at $6 per pier versus $60 per pier. So I'm doing 13 of the piers like that. And if I can do that quickly enough in my head, 13 at 60 is gonna be $780 is what it would cost to do 13 piers like that. To do 13 piers the way I'm going to do it for the support, at $6 a piece, you're looking at what, $78? So by doing it this way, I'm saving $700. Right, and accomplishing the same thing. So, you know, I'm doing this whole build on a tight budget. I have to save money wherever I can, and I have to think about things, right? I want the stability and the extra security of actual piers down in the ground. A 12-inch sonotube, you know, with the concrete in it and the rebar in it, that's like 50 square inches of concrete or something like that. Anyway, the way it came out, it holds like 100,000 pounds, one of those. I'm gonna have 8 of those. Then I'm gonna have the other blocks just to help support these, what is gonna be 8 inches of beam running across it. So I'm gonna have, you know, every 8 feet is gonna be a beam, or is gonna be a pier, every 8 feet going the length of it. And then there's gonna be one in the middle and one on the outside. That there's gonna be a pier, then at 10 feet a pier, 10 feet a pier. My 2x8s, my 10-foot 2x8s will span 11.8 9.2 feet. I'm going to be spanning 9.10 inches. So 9 feet, 2 inches. They'll do 11 feet, 2 inches, something like that. So I'm not worried about anything structure. That structure is going to be plenty sufficient. But the $700 I can save by not actually pouring piers for every, you know, pouring the concrete for every pier, I'm going to be able to save and buy my two doors. You know, that's how I'm looking at this as I go along, as I price things. I mean, I went back and forth with 20 different sizes and configurations to build to figure out which would be, number one, the most economical build, and something that I can carry all the material out here. Because I can't afford to pay for delivering everything. I can't afford to buy it all at one time. I have to buy it like this, you know. I was coming out here to take care of Creamer, so I picked those up. That was $86 or something like that, because they only had seven of them. So I ordered another one with the next load of lumber that I bring out. But that's going to be the foundation. I know people were asking about it. A pier and beam foundation. I'm going to have 8 of them actually poured concrete with rebar in it at the corners and in the middle. So it's not going to go anywhere. We're going to be in good shape with that. And I'm going to have $700 that I get to save by not having to put in 21 of those things, only having to put in 8. So that's how I'm looking at it. Anyway, it's cold out here. It's a cold day. Damp. Oh my gosh. Cloudy, overcast, it's ugly out here, and windy. So I'm not gonna spend a whole lot of time out here talking to you. I got the heater going in the cabin. I'm gonna go in the cabin for a while and warm up a bit. But I did wanna answer some questions on what kind of foundation I was gonna do. So now you know, a pier and beam foundation. A very good foundation. There's no problem with that. No way I can afford to have a foundation, a slab poured, a basement dug, a block foundation on footers. I'm not going to do that. You know, I'm not looking to build a house that's going to last 200 years. I'm looking to build a house that I can build and that I can afford to build and have no mortgage on it when I'm done with it. That's the whole plan. I'll show you guys how you can do it. If you want to follow along, remember, subscribe, like and share this video so other people get ideas. That's all I'm trying to do, is send out ideas on how you can do this and maybe get some ideas on things I should do. But that's what this whole channel is about, and that's where we're headed. Had a great live stream last night. A lot of fun. Gonna do it again Wednesday night. This is, by the way, this is Sunday, December 19th, and if you want to help support the channel, I got my P.O. box, my PayPal me, all that information in the description. I'm working on my merchandise. You can buy, you know, some merchandise. It's all going into this house build. Hope you all like it. God bless y'all. God bless America. I'm out. Creamer. You made me feed. You get up there and eat. She's full. Or he's full.